bless their marriage. God, I pray that they would keep their eyes focused on you. God, we thank you for this day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You may be seated. Now, I'm going to give the charge for Lay and Daniel. Now, normally, I charge by the hour. But newlyweds, as we all know, don't have that much money. So I will make it 5 minutes, I promise. Lay, before we get into this, and Daniel, before we get into this, there's been a lot that's going into this moment. And I want you to take some time and soak it in. So, Lay, what is your bridesmaids? Soak it all in. Daniel, what is your groomsmen? Soak it all in. Lay and Daniel, as you look around at a room full of people that love you, that have invested in you, that have prayed for you, that have sacrificed, and we're all here for this special moment. So I want you to take it all in. We've done a lot of running, a lot of photos, a lot of rehearsal, a lot of eating. So we're just going to soak it all in, okay? The Bible says in Psalms 118, verse 24, it says, this is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day you will look back 30, 40, 50 years from now, and you'll never forget. This is one of those monumental days, so I would encourage you to not just enjoy the day, but also to enjoy the moment. Let me give you some things that will help make marriage special and some stuff that I think will help newlyweds. First thing is this, love each other. Love each other. It's easy to love on your wedding day. When the makeup's all done and the teeth are brushed and the face is shaved and the hair's combed. But there's going to be days where it's hard to wake up in the morning and love the person that you're saying I do to today. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 13:13, and now abideth faith, hope, charity, these three. The greatest of these is charity. Build your marriage on love. A love for the Lord and a love for each other. Things will come and go. The cars will come and go. The possessions will come and go. There will be ups and downs in life. But love will still remain when that's all you have. Stay in love with each other. Love is not a choice. I'm sorry, love is a choice. It is a choice. It is not an emotion. It's a choice that we make every day. The Bible says in Romans 12:10, be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another. Love each other. Number two, lean on each other. Lean on each other. There will be ups, there will be downs. There will be days where the bank account is as high as it is today. There will be times where the health may not be what it is today. There'll be ups and downs. Learn to lean on each other. The Bible says in Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. You will have to learn how to work with and how to depend on each other. You're a team. Work together. Through leaning on each other, you'll learn how to live. When you lean on each other, when you help each other, when you support each other, lean on the Lord. Not every day is like your wedding day. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Okay? Lean on the Lord. Not every day is like today. Now, most days will be like today. You will probably have more good days than bad days, but there will be those days where it's hard. Support each other. Help each other. The Bible says in Psalms 127:1, except the Lord build a house, they labor in vain that build it. God is the one that will sustain you. God is the one that will sustain your marriage. Lean on each other. Lean on the Lord. Lean on God first, and lean on your spouse. Lastly, live. Live for each other as you both live for the Lord. The Bible says in Galatians 5:13, by love, serve one another. Now, we all know this, the famous statement or cliche, happy wife, happy life. That's a lie. It's happy spouse, happy house. Make each other happy. Serve each other. Live for each other. Don't be selfish. You're working together. You're on a team. Live for each other. Your days of individuality in about 10 minutes are going to be over. So work together. Live for each other. Help each other. You're not a competitor. You're a completer. Live for the Lord together. serve the Lord, we serve it as a family. Should the Lord bless and give you children, serve the Lord with your family. Teach them and nurture that mission of the Lord. Your marriage will last longer than your wedding day. Build it. Make the marriage matter. Don't waste worry on the way. Today, try some things that may not go according to plan. They may not go according to the script. Enjoy the day. But remember, you're building a marriage. You're not building a wedding day. Build your marriage strong. So love each other, lean on each other, and live for the Lord.
Daniel, Neal, will you have this woman to be your lawful wedded wife? Will you love her, honor and keep her in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, forsaking all others, keeping thee holding unto her so long as you both shall live? Do you so promise?
I do.
Lehuanani, will you have this man to be your lawful wedded husband? Will you love him, honor and keep him in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live, do you so promise?
May I have the rings?
It's been a tradition for Christian weddings for a gift to be given between the bride and the groom. And a ring has been chosen as that gift. A ring is made out of precious materials to show the value of the love that these young people have for each other and for the Lord. It is also a ring. It has no beginning, no end. It's eternal. As Rob said earlier, there are three that abide, faith, hope, and charity. But the greatest of these is charity. Okay. As you place the ring on the third finger of the left hand, would you repeat after me? With this ring, I thee wed. And with all my worldly goods and my heart's best affection, I thee endow. As you place the ring on the third finger of the left hand, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With all my worldly goods and my heart's best affection, I thee endow. Daniel, will you repeat after me the following words? I, Daniel, kneel. Take thee, Lehuanani, Luce. To be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, till death do us part. Lehuanani, would you repeat after me the following words? I, Lehuanani, take thee, Daniel, Neal, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, till death do us part.
When it feels like God.
trust you and believe, 'cause you're the God who takes care of me. When it feels like I can't even take,
as much then as you, Daniel, and you, Lehuanani, have offered yourselves each to the other, believing it is God's will to become one flesh, and believing that God has led you to this place, as your pastor, an officer of the love in the state of Hawaii, and minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, in the presence of your family, these friends, and your Heavenly Father, I take great pleasure in pronouncing you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. What God had joined together, let no man put asunder.
Thank you.
the groom are asking the close family members stay in the auditorium for pictures. The rest of the